Hey everyone, we're going to do a quick tutorial on inserting equations and math and chemistry symbols in Microsoft Word. So you can see here I have Microsoft Word open and I've gone ahead and typed out some of the key things that you might need to do in a chemistry class like this. The first thing we're going to do is insert an equation. A lot of people go up here to the insert menu and then off to the side there's a button for inserting an equation like that, and then that gives you all these buttons where you can like click on stuff to insert what you need. And you can do equations this way, but we don't need to. So there's a keyboard shortcut for inserting an equation. If you have a Windows computer, it is Alt and then the equal sign, and if you have a Mac, then you hit Control and then the equal sign. So I'm going to hit Alt equals on my keyboard, and that inserts an equation. Now I can type out a chemical equation. If I want to make a subscript, I can do an underscore and then the subscript. And then as soon as I hit the space bar on my computer, it inserts that for me. If I want to make an arrow, then I can type a dash and then the like greater than sign, and that automatically transforms into an arrow. So that's what it looked like before it reformatted, and then I can just keep typing. That one I don't have to hit spacebar to format. If you want to insert a superscript, then you have to hit shift 6 to get a caret, and then you can type your charge, but you do have to watch it because it's not the smartest thing in the world. So you can use the arrow keys to navigate and insert and where you want things. So you can type your chemical equations much faster this way. Additionally, if you want to number your equations, I believe you do a number one like this. And then when you hit enter, it numbers it for you. Also, if you want to do Greek letters, then you can type the Greek letter name like delta. It is case sensitive, so if you want a capital delta, you have to do a capital D. If you do a lowercase d, then you'll get a lowercase delta. This way you can do your enthalpy values. Let's see what else. Fractions are good. In the equation editor for Word, you need to just kind of do whatever you want in the numerator, and you can put that in parentheses, and then whatever you want in the denominator. And put parentheses around it so that it's clear to the computer what to put in the numerator, what to put in the denominator. As soon as you hit the space bar, it will reformat. To get a multiplication sign, you can do times, like that, slash times, or you can do C dot to get the center dot. Now, another thing you can do is to quickly get your equations in here. Well, not your equations, but as your regular typing, that's how you would do your math. There's an option that's not on by default, and so you should go in here to, where is it? It's under autocorrect, proofing, there we go. Autocorrect options. Go to autocorrect options and then go over to the tab for math autocorrect and check this box for use math autocorrect outside of math regions. This also gives you a list of all of the symbols and how to make them so that Microsoft Word recognizes them. So what this does is it allows you outside of that equation editor to type those same things in order to get your degree Celsius or delta. It won't do the subscripts, but at least you can get your other symbols in there without having to go up to the insert equation. And so Hope those tips save you some time in your education. If you're in the sciences or any kind of technical field or foreign language that's going to use a lot of those different symbols, you're going to need to use these equation editors quite a bit. So, good luck.